We've been using DDR4 on our computers for quite a while now, and while it's had impressive longevity, we're actually getting to the point where a new generation of memory will be necessary to keep up with the increasing demands we're putting on our computers, as well as with processors that have more and more cores and need better memory channel utilization efficiency to handle larger amounts of data more quickly. DDR5 will be hitting the mainstream in the near future to address these needs, but how is it different from DDR4? Well, DDR5 keeps the same number of pins and length of DDR4 modules. The height is slightly decreased, and the PCB is actually slightly thinner. However, that doesn't mean you can just plug DDR4 into a DDR5 system, or vice versa. The keying notch on the bottom of the memory PCB is in a different location, and the pins themselves have very different uses. More importantly, DDR5 will offer larger capacities. Currently, DDR4 tops out at a die size of 16 gigabits, meaning that the maximum capacity of a regular, unbuffered DIMM is 32 gigs per module. With DDR5, that limit gets quadrupled to 64 gigabits per die, so a standard system could easily have 4 times the capacity that it does currently. And even if you don't end up needing to install 512 gigabytes of RAM in your system, you wouldn't need nearly as many modules then for a content creation, gaming, or streaming powerhouse. And these are all applications that are likely going to use more RAM over the coming years. Now, as with every DDR generation transition, not only has the density increased, but the data rates have also increased, in this case, double. When DDR4 was launched, the JEDEC standard for data rates was 2133 megatransfers per second, and over the years, that increased to 3200. With the launch of DDR5, however, the JEDEC standard is now 4800 megatransfers per second, and Corsair just shipped its first kits at 6400 megatransfers per second. These higher data rates mean a massive increase in memory bandwidth. Another big change in DDR5 is the addition of the PMIC, or Power Management IC. With previous DDR generations, all voltages were provided directly by the motherboard to the module. DDR5 instead takes a single bulk 5-volt connection from the motherboard, and the PMIC splits that into the appropriate individual voltages for the RAM ICs themselves. Moving the PMIC onto the module instead of the motherboard allows for better voltage regulation and reduced electrical noise. DDR5 also lowers the default voltage from 1.2 to 1.1 volts, meaning lower power consumption in situations where preserving battery life is critical. DDR5 for desktops is now here to use alongside new CPUs and will become the new standard as adoption rates increase over time. Corsair features a full lineup of DDR5 modules to serve the needs of any system, and I would highly encourage you to check them out.